Yo, this piece so far is a lot more technically demanding than I thought it'd be.
What's up, my Orbit fam? I'm Chris Tovu, and welcome to my channel. For my longtime Orbit subs, it's been a while. I've missed y'all. So, I've been away from YouTube and from K-pop for like the past 6-7 months now, basically forever, living under a rock. So, yeah, I'm pretty late to this whole LOONA hula hoop party. I'm so sorry for that, but you know, better late than never, am I right? And I gotta say, I did check out the MV the day it dropped, and I loved it. Like, the callbacks to the previous eras, like the pre-debut content was just... I was in heaven, alright? I was in heaven. Like, the outfits, the pairing, the objects, like, there was so much to pull from it, you know? It just totally brought me down memory lane. And, the song is so good. It's like my pick-me-up song, alright? Whenever I'm down, I'll listen to Hula Hoop, morale instantly goes up. Like, such a catchy song. MV was adorable, and like I said, the callbacks to all the previous eras. Part of me is even like, there's gotta be some Lunaverse lore in there. There's gotta be. So yeah, overall the package was incredible, and I'm actually really surprised that the MV had like so few views. I expected it to have a lot more than that, so it's a bit of a bummer. But yeah, well, I'm excited, right? I'm excited to finally see what this choreo is about. Because I feel like most groups, they don't really give us dance practice videos for their Japanese releases. So, I mean, I guess BBC, you know, they did one thing right. Alright, my orbits, no. BBC, been messing up a bit. Definitely messing up a bit. But anyways, if you're new to me, new to my channel, understand I love these ladies from left to right. I adore them. They're one of my old groups. And yeah, chances are I'll be fanboy freaking out, meaning my personal volume is gonna go from here to the stratosphere and beyond. Meaning your eardrums are probably going to burst during these moments. So if I were you, I'd definitely lower the volume to protect yourselves. I'm not trying to murder anyone in my second video back after like 6 months, all right? And also my format for my newer viewers is, you know, watch the dance practice. I will talk throughout, but I don't pause, or I just basically talk, comment, react, and then I go through a second time, and that's when I will pause, and I will talk about the things I liked about a piece, the things I didn't like about a piece, and then just some random other filler stuff. I've been dancing for a minute now, started formal training when I was 5, taught through uni, competed through uni. After I graduated, that's basically when I retired, and now I'm more of an admirer of dance, all right? But anyways, I have been talking on long enough, so without further ado, let's get into it. Okay, so we got our first LOONA video in forever. I'm so excited. Jinsoul looking amazing. And that was so cute. Oh my god. Step out to Avlo. Everyone cheesing. Ah, oh, Jinsoul, what a visual. Oh, Eve, what a visual. What? And yo, that opening frame, gorgeous. Taechu and Hanjin. Oh, I love that. I love that right there. Challenge formation cannon from front to back, low to high. Let's get a Heejin. I love how they're framing right now with the hands. Oh, go on, that was so cute. Kim look taking point. Visual. Oh, yes, make way for Mama Bird. The go on, yes. I love the way they're pairing off in this piece. Let's step out, make way. Yo, this piece so far is a lot more technically demanding than I thought it'd be. Oh, Mimi and Yujin! Oh my god, so far I'm loving the little pairings they're doing about this piece. And Baby Wolf taking point. Look at them, so clean with the execution. Oh, I love that. I love that segment of the little cannon right there, the pull off. Oh, I love the hit, look, inward focus. Oh, look at Tadpole, look at her. Okay, let's go, Baby Wolf. Ah, Masuki with the cannon. Oh, let's get a Hanjin. Oh, inverse ISO on Mama Bird. Oh my god, Jinsoul. Oh my god. Miss Hasu Young trying to end me. Jeez. Oh, they all look so good. Oh, I saw the go on BB connection right there. Oh. Ah!
my god, the pairings! I love this.
Oh, yo, choreographer knows what we want. Hunjin killing it up for it. I love that. I love the way the work go on for right there. Comma. Nice. Yeah, the transition, seriously, from one formation to the next, just... Oh. Jinsoul, just... The wink Jinsoul! I love that slowdown. And the high note... That's so cute! Oh, yes! Yo, the elegance... God. Oh, okay, twice now. Jinsoul, that's twice now she's winked.
Oh, she's so adorable. I love that too, little reach out. Oh, the baby.
Oh my god. Yo.
It's so good to be back. It's so good to be back with Luna.
That choreo was incredible. I did not expect it to be so technically demanding. I mean, we saw so little. And I suppose I shouldn't be surprised as Luna. Like, they're, like, in my opinion, the strongest fourth-gen group when it comes to their collective dance ability. So I shouldn't be surprised, but I thought it'd be just like a cutesy, you know, kind of fun, lighthearted piece of choreo, which it was. At times, it was very cute, it was very lighthearted, but it was also technically demanding. So yeah, obviously, we're going into round two, I'll be breaking down what I love. There's nothing I didn't like about this piece, all right? So you don't have to worry about that. It's all gonna be what I loved. So yeah, we pausing and talking about the good stuff, and there's plenty to talk about.
That's so cute, oh my god. And yo, Jinsoul.
Jinsoul, the amount of times Jinsoul winked in this piece just writes me. Okay, yeah, throughout this entire piece, these transitions are so seamless, man. From one formation to the next, seamless. And they're like transitioning with purpose, with life. You know, they're not just simply walking from one formation to the next. There is a dance movement. They're working with levels, bringing the hands up, slightly bending down, man. The Luna choreographer, whomever they bring in, always knows to utilize the talents of these dancers while also creating these grand pieces, these gorgeous pieces that work with so many aspects of the science of dance. Meaning, you have these level changes, right? So when you have your high, low changes in level, basically, when you stand tall, my long-time viewers, I'm so sorry, you've heard this a million times. My newer viewers, we have our level plan, right? When you are standing tall dancing normally, mid-level plane, anything on the ground, low-level plane, anything up high, so bringing the hands up or aerials or lifts, that's high-level plane, right? When you have changes in level plane, high-low, high-lows, create natural tunnel effect for the viewer's eyes, drawing them in, getting you to focus on what's happening toward the center. And they do that so well with the transitioning, working levels, and then when they have their set formations, their framing, basically the dancers that are not the focus of the piece at the moment, so like off the sides, they're working levels, they're drawing you in toward the middle. They do it so freaking well. Anyway, but yeah, transitions are seamless. I love the extension. I love the hands. Full extension on these movements. That's attention to detail. That's so cute. The way they work their ISOs to have individual shine in this piece, love it. It's just so adorable. Make way, circle around, love that. The amount of focus on Gohan in this piece, so great. And again, the pairing off. I love how they went about pairing off throughout this entire piece. Love this too. There's these grand open movements on these hard counts. So cute, Yujin and Vivi. Look how light they are on their feet as well. Like, the next time they do a boy group cover, it's gonna blow everyone away. Segment camera, they're two pulling in, center group, and then the flanks go in as well. But yo, they're so light on their feet. Like, the next time they do a boy group cover, it's... Oof, the internet will break, alright? The industry will break, because technically speaking, like, just watching how they're going about in this piece, they're so light on their feet, but we know Luna can bring that weight to their hits. So when they finally do another boy group or do like aim for a more masculine type piece, like you're gonna have that hard heavy hit with that pause, which you see in masculine type choreo, but their ability to bring themselves back up so quickly, like that's what differentiates them from other groups that try to do boy group covers, try to do masculine type pieces, you know, when you apply these heavy hard hits and you can't bring yourself up in time. Luna doesn't have that problem, all right? You're seeing bits of that in this piece, even though this is mostly a light, proper posture piece, which you typically see in traditional girl group choreo, where you have upward posture, plenty of handwork. We're seeing, this might be like the most handwork I've seen Luna do, like, ever. But continuing. Look at Yeojin, bringing it. Oh my god, Yeojin's so adorable. And this cannon right here. I love that. Not only, it's the attention to detail, right? Full extension, fingers out the cannon, which was so cute, and then pop, bring it back in. Love that. Little things. It's the little things they focus on. That's what separates great choreographers and unbelievable choreographers, is the attention to detail. And I think that's like number one. And Miss Hasu Young with the midriff and just her general charisma, incredible. And Heejin rocking the hat. I love that. Mama Bird and Vivi, yes? Hunjin. Hunjin's such an underrated dancer. She's so skilled. I love to see her take point. I love this. I love the amount of focus on Gohan in this piece. But that right there to bring her to focus, that was so nice. Pull in, the rest of the group pulls in. Call up, step out right there. Like I said, seamless transitions. That's the wink! You see that wink? God! Jinsol trying to end me. The focus. And right there. So cute. I love the way. So cute! And this is so cute! God! Oh my god. And look at Chu's smile. Oh my god. Look at Vivi too. Yo, they've improved so much. And this was months ago. Oh my god. I love these ladies. But they've improved so much from the last time I saw them. Or maybe just like nostalgia or the fact that I'm just totally biased whipped right now. But technically speaking, they're so gifted with their dance, and I did not expect this piece to be a technical piece of choreo, but yo, it was technical, you know? It just, the vibe I got from the MV was just gonna be a fun, cutesy, lighthearted thing. The fact we got a dance practice, I was like, okay, it's just gonna be a, you know, just a fun old time, you know? Just a fun, cute time, which totally was, but also very technically demanding in what they had to do, how they had to execute as a group, how they were in sync, how they went about transitioning, how they went about basically applying these hits. They're not, this piece didn't have so much heavy hits, but you had full extension. You had attention to details with the fingers, right? You had how linear they were, how fluid they were. It was a great piece. It was a great piece, and this was months ago, all right? So now that they're on Queendom, and they're gonna be bringing it, like, oh my god, I am so not ready. I'll be reacting to their open show Queendom performance, like, right as soon as I'm done with this. And, it'll be really great to see how far they've come along from this to what they show us in that. So yeah, I'm really excited. But yeah, Luna, they continue to cement their position, at least in my heart and my mind, that they are, performance-wise, dance-wise, the strongest group in the fourth gen, collectively speaking, maybe even in the industry now, you know? Especially considering they continue to grow, you know, they continue to adapt, and they're so more versatile with their concepts they can bring, not only with their, you know, their MVs or their stages, but with their dance, all right? It is not easy to change up concept mid-choreo or change up concept entirely, like mid-comeback, or with varying comebacks, when you are trained in a certain way. Like, a few Luna members are trained in ballet or classical-type dance. Focus on heavy posture or high posture, elegance with the hands, you know, light on your feet. Hip hop, which they're capable of doing, which we've seen them do, or hip hop fundamental dance, where it's like very weighted, very heavy, or
boy group masculine dance, they kill with. And for them to be able to do that coming from the backgrounds they come from is unbelievable. All right, that shows dance versatility, dance range, and they have it. All right, they definitely have it. And the gaps between the members and their dance skill is slowly closing. It's been closing over the years, but it's getting even closer as well. So now you have a greater collective picture. Like, Eve is still, in my opinion, the strongest dancer in the group, like with her dance fundamentals and her technique. But yeah, the gap between the other members is definitely a lot closer than it was at debut. At debut, it was glaring. Like, you could tell who's the weak link, who's the strongest. You know, it was so easy for me to look at Luna and be like, oh, the one with the long black hair, she's the strongest one. This is Butterfly, by the way, when I checked out Butterfly for the first time. She's the one that stood out to me the most, you know? It was pretty easy to see that. And then, you know, Kimla, Heejin, I think Heejin was a standout during that era for me as well. They also stood out. But anyways, I've been talking on quite a bit about random stuff. But so yeah, thank you so much for watching, you guys. I'm sorry, I'm rusty, right? I haven't been doing this. It's been like half a year. I'm rusty. But yeah, thank you so much for checking me out. If you like PC, please hit that like button. If you like some more, please subscribe. And if you have any questions or recommendations or, you know, just anything to say, you know, leave it down below, and I'll do my best to reply to you. Otherwise, I will see you in another video, possibly the Queendom reaction, or I will see you next week. Take it easy.